Hello, my name is Senthil Kumar, roll number 1703028, and I'm a student of the 2017-19 PGPBM batch at IIM Trichy Chennai campus. Over the next few minutes, I'm going to speak about the recent steep hike in minimum support price, or known as MSP, that the central government raised for kharif crops. MSP can give the farmers the much promised 50% return on input costs. This is a politically astute move that can ease the farm distress and boost rural demand if it is implemented effectively, but at the same time it can also invoke inflation. Before getting into the details, let us first understand what is MSP. MSP, or minimum support price, this is a form of market intervention by the Government of India to insure agricultural producers against any sharp fall in farm prices. The MSP, it is announced by the Government of India at the beginning of the sowing season for crops, especially the kharif crops, and bases the recommendation of Commission for Agricultural Costs and Prices, that is the CACP. MSP is this price fixed, that is by the government. It protects the producers, the farmers, against excessive fall in prices during bumper production years. The minimum support prices, they act as a guarantee for the produce from the government. Major objectives for the support of the farmers: from distressed sales, procure food grains for public distribution. Now, in case the market price for the commodity falls below the announced minimum price due to bumper production, and maybe due to even a glut in the market, government agencies purchase the entire quantity offered by the farmers at the announced minimum price. The minimum guaranteed prices are fixed to set a floor below the market prices so that it cannot fall. Now, till the 1970s, government announced two types of administered prices. One was the MSP and this is the procurement price. Now, how is the MSP determined? The commission takes into account, apart from a comprehensive view of the entire structure of the economy of a particular commodity or group of commodities, the following factors: one, cost of production, changes in the input prices, input and output price parity, trends in market prices, demand and supply, intercrop price parity, could be the industrial cost structure, the cost of living, effect of general price level, the international market price, parity between prices paid and received by the farmers, cost of production per quintal in various regions of the country, and several similar changes. For the demand related information, that is the total and per capita consumption trends and capacity of the processing industry, is a very important factor. Now, what are the crops covered? It's a very general question. Crops such as cereals, which include paddy, wheat, bajra, johar, etc., pulses like tur dal, moong dal, oil seeds, groundnut, sunflower, soya bean, it could be raw cotton, jute, coconut husk, etc. The government of India said this is a historic move, and around 15,000 crores it allocated and, you know, fulfilled the promise that it made during the budget year. MSP would also be determined on the principle that harvest should get the farmers at least 150% cost of planting and tending to the crops. The West Bengal agriculture advisor is one person among the opposition who has welcomed this. He says that West Bengal is prepared with all the infrastructure to provide higher MSP to the farmers. Last year, for example, West Bengal had procured around 50 lakh tons of paddy, and they say that this year they can procure more. The implementation of MSP is always going to remain a challenge. Leaders of farmer bodies said increase is good, but it did not factor into the recent increase in fuel prices like diesel, which is used for tractors, and barely 10% of the farmers were able to sell to the procurement agencies. The corporate sector, on the other hand, feels that the higher sales of consumer goods like motorcycles, tractors and other farm equipments, that is, this increase in MSP will actually result in disposable income in the hands of the rural customers, that is the farmers or people living in villages who are primarily associated with agriculture. And they say that this would certainly boost consumer sentiments. That will be a dual impact. prices of raw materials could go up, which could lead to a price hike. At the same time, higher farm income will also lead to an increase in consumption across segments, from high ticketing farms like smaller FMCG products. While this announced hike in MSP is in accordance with Government of India's efforts towards improving the farmer incomes, whether they actually translate into higher realization for farmers, this remains to be seen. For instance, despite a healthy expansion of the MSP for pulses in the financial year 2018 and some of the procurements by the government agencies, the actual price realization in the market, it was sort of muted, with the wholesale prices falling somewhere below the MSP in some of the months until now. So in addition to providing MSP at 50% or more over the cost of production, there is a need to streamline this procurement process and the PDS network so the farmer derives the maximum benefit. There is an allegation by the opposition that this is being done for vote bank politics, but again, this will be tested in the time to come. All the kharif crops that will be harvested in the month of October to November, this is when the three main states like Chhattisgarh, Madhya Pradesh and Rajasthan go into the polls, and this entire policy of the revision in the MSP will be tested. So friends, the jury is out whether the government's politically astute move will actually help the farmers. Thank you very much for watching. Have a good day. Bye.